All right, welcome back to the final part of the Razor Crest series. In this video, we're going to be setting up our composition for final preview rendering. So basically, this is something that you would send the client to have a look at, not really final frames or anything, but just something that the client can see for the first time. We're going to use H.264. It's very common to use ProRes or DNX HD, but I'm going to show you something that would work for pretty much any device. We're going to be using the media encoder as opposed to just rendering from After Effects. And we're also going to be setting up our visual effects slate. If you would like to use the same slate, it is available on my Patreon. Otherwise, you can create your own. All right, let's get started with the final part of this series. Okay, so all of this though needs to be pre-composed again. So we're going to do Control Shift C, and then this time we're going to say shake and grain. And inside our master comp now, which is comp one, this is where we're going to apply our slate and then name this whatever our preview is going to be called. But to do that, we need to make this 1080 again. So if yours is not 1080, you need to make this 1080. So it's Control K to bring up your composition settings. Then we're going to type in 1920 by 1080. And then here for the duration, we need to add one more frame for the slate. So it's going to be 201 frames. Click OK. And then you'll notice that this is extended everything by one frame. Go right to the very first frame, so frame zero. Click page down to step forward one frame. Select this layer and then click the left bracket key. So then the very first frame is completely black. It's actually completely transparent. This is where the slate goes. You should not see your ship with your slate. Like, they should be separate. Okay. You could also just zoom in all the way and then just move this over like that. Whichever way you like, I prefer using page down and then the left bracket key, but it's up to you. All right, so let's grab our slate. So slate for VFX. Make sure that if you're in the motion graphics class, you use the visual effects slate for this assignment. We're gonna open that up. We're gonna grab the slate right here. Okay, now remember, we gotta open up the slate comp, grab everything with Control A, click Control X on your keyboard to cut all those layers, go back to comp one, then Control V to paste them in. This is how we transfer all of those layers to our new composition. This is to prevent us from having to run a script, basically. This is the only way to really do this. For the description, type in Razor Crest Landing. For the rest of this, apart from the artist name, this is not me, this is you. For the rest of this, everything should be automatic. So the frame rate should be 24. This is automatically determined. Switch this back to full resolution so we can see this more clearly. Everything else should be just automated like this. Okay. Last thing for the comp name. This is going to be whatever your composition is called. So Control K or composition settings. And then this is Annie270 underscore project 02 underscore whatever version number you're currently on. So I made a mistake here. We should have saved this file as version 2. So we'll click version 2, click OK. I need to up version this right away. We should have done that as soon as we opened our composition. So that's version 2. If you're on version 3, give me a version 3. If you're on version 20, give me a version 20. You're probably not on a version 20 though. You're up versioning too much. If you want to do increments and saves, you could have version 1.2, version 1.3, or whatever. Increments and saves don't count, right? So every time you like do a proper render, that's what's important, right? You don't want to confuse yourself and clients with like really elaborate version numbers. Version 1, 2, 3, 4, sometimes it'll be like version 2B, or like a version 3A, B, and C, all those three separate files. That's pretty a common convention, but you just want to do something like this, okay? Fit this to 100 and then step through this. On the letterboxing, this is where you're going to see your frame counter and then the file name right here. And then we're good to go. And on our slate here, obviously, because our slate is using so many different frames, we're going to click on the little shy icon, gets rid of all of those. And then we can go up to composition, add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. Click on this. We'll open up the Media Encoder. None of this is new information. This is going to be pretty much the same thing that we did for the previous two exercises, but I thought we would do a little bit of review on this. So this should pop up here. If it takes a little bit for you, it's fine. Sometimes this can be pretty slow. Sometimes it can be pretty fast. It just depends on your computer and just how it's feeling, I guess, because sometimes mine is really fast and sometimes mine takes forever. So this name right here is the same name as your composition. If this says Slate, you did it wrong. You need to go back and fix that. We don't need audio exported. It shouldn't really matter if it's on or not, but we don't need that channel at all. Now for this, we need to do, you can do hardware encoding or you can do software encoding. If it's on software, you could do something like 15 and 25. I know I sometimes change these around. Basically, anything between this is probably going to be good. 15 is going to be too low on the maximum though. So on the maximum, I do like to give it a little bit more. Sometimes I say 20 and 25. If it's for YouTube, it would be 35 and 45 at 4K. But for an assignment like this, let's just do 20, 25. That makes sure there's not going to be a lot of grain. If you want to make sure it's slightly smaller and better compressed, you can do two pass. This will take twice as long to render though. If you have a graphics card, like if you were rendering with V-Ray's GPU mode, you might consider switching this to hardware encoding. If you switch it to hardware encoding though, you can't do variable bit rates like this. It's constant. So I'm going to leave that on software. Use maximum rendered quality. And then by default, this is going to save in an AME folder. If that's fine for you, no problem. That's cool. But I'm going to make a new folder called previews. And in the previews folder, this is where I would save out versions of this. Because sometimes those AME folders, they kind of get lost. So let's just do that. Click OK. Click on the start queue. And this is going to vary quite a bit. If you're rendering to a flash drive, this might take forever. This is going to depend on your system. So just remember that VBR 2 pass will take twice as long. So if you start this off and you see something like 30 minutes or an hour or something crazy, just drop it back down to VBR 1 pass or switch it to hardware encoding, which doesn't have variable bit rate at all, and just render that. Okay. So VBR 2 pass is more to do with how it optimizes the compression, and you tend to get better compression and perhaps a slightly smaller file size, but you don't have to bother with that for this. All right, so when that is done, simply click on the output file location. We'll open up an Explorer window. You can play it with whatever player you like, but I'm gonna pull this back into After Effects. After Effects is a really good player as well. Like it makes sure it plays every single frame. So I'm going to just double click this, open up a footage tab, drag that out. The first frame should be your slate. Now on your slate, check to make sure all the information is correct. Check to make sure that at the very last frame says frame 200, and that's what the length is going to be. If your shot for whatever reason is a little bit longer or a little bit shorter than that, the length still needs to match whatever you submit. Okay. All right. So now we can play this back and just have one final look at this. Hopefully it's good to go. If you need to make more tweaks, then go ahead and make those tweaks and then render this out again. So there are some things that I would fix. I'm still not 100% happy with the dust. It fades a little bit too quickly still, in my opinion. I'd like it to be a little thicker, more like this at the very end, but it's better than what it was. And we could go back and forth all day with that. There's also the sharpness of the shadow here, what we never even talked about. If you were trying to get a softer shadow, let's say you're doing like overcast, that would be the sun size in V-Ray, that if you increase the sun size, it's going to increase your shadow softness. So that's something else we didn't talk about. If you have any specific issues with your scene or you want me to take a look at it, I'd be more than happy to help. All right, so once that is all good, just submit this to Canvas. When I grade it, if I need to take a look at something just to make sure you did something right, I might ask for that. So keep all of your Maya files and keep all of your After Effects files and everything. And you might also want to resubmit this later on in the semester for more points. Okay, so this should have served as a pretty good introduction to compositing directly from Maya. And even if you have no interest in visual effects, If you have interest in rendering from Maya or rendering for whatever app you choose to use in the future, the things that we've done here are not Maya dependent and not really After Effects dependent. They're just pretty foundational level compositing. And even if you were to do something like this for just a still, so something that wasn't even moving, you can use a lot of the same techniques and a lot of the same principles. All right, so finish this up, get that submitted, and then we can move on to the final set of assignments, and then the semester will be over. So if you have any questions, please let me know as soon as possible, because this takes a fair amount of time to render out. You want to make sure that all your corrections are made as soon as possible. So thank you for making it through the entire series, and I look forward to see what you guys come up with. Thank you so much for watching. If you made it through this entire lecture series, I really appreciate it. Put a huge amount of time into this, so I hope you enjoyed it. But most importantly, I hope you learned something about Maya, V-Ray, and After Effects. As always, if you have any questions, I'd be more than happy to help, and I'd love to see what you guys come up with if you use this as reference. Anyway, thanks again for watching. Hopefully it won't take another full year before I release new content for this channel, but we'll see how it goes. All right, guys, until next time.